Hi everyone, once again myself Girish Kumar Singh speaking with you to make you understand one content of your biology chapter, the fundamental unit of life, and the topic is the nucleus. Dear students, the nucleus is the most important, conspicuous and the largest organelle of a eukaryotic cell. It is visible under light microscope and its fine structure has been revealed by electron microscope. We can observe deeply stained rounded nucleus in a properly stained preparation. Stained with safranine or methylene blue solution. Fine structure, properly stained preparation of cheek squamous epithelial cells of human beings or epidermal peel of onion bulb under a microscope. In animal cells, it is generally centrally located. However, in plant cells, it is pushed to the side due to the presence of large cell vacuole. Nucleus contains the hereditary material for regulating cell activities as well as for transfer to the next generation. Prokaryotic cells do not have an organized nucleus with a nuclear envelope. They have a nucleoid, which is highly folded circular DNA molecule without a membrane. Generally, there is a single nucleus in each cell. Such cells are termed as uninucleate. Some cells possess two nuclei. These are termed binucleate. You can take the example of protozoan, paramecium, caudatum. Some cells possess more than two nuclei. They are termed multinucleate. The shape of resting nucleus is usually spherical, but it may vary in shape under special conditions. Chemically, the nucleus is composed of about 80% protein, 12% DNA, deoxyribose nucleic acid, 5% are Dear students, this slide is showing you the structure of the nucleus. You are seeing the different components. These components are nuclear envelope or karyotheca, nuclear sap or karyolymph, chromatin material, nucleolus and nuclear matrix. Let us know about everyone somewhat in detail. Nuclear envelope. Nucleus is bounded by two nuclear membranes, together referred to as nuclear envelope. Please keep on seeing on the picture. The two nuclear membranes are designated as outer membrane and inner membrane. These enclose a fluid-filled space in between called intermembrane space or perinuclear space. Each membrane resembles the cell membrane in structure. The nuclear envelope separates the nuclear contents from the cytoplasm. It is perforated by numerous minute circular nuclear pores for movement of materials in and out of the nucleus. The outer membrane bears ribosomes on the cytoplasmic side, and at places it also connected with a system of membranes called endoplasmic reticulum, which you studied earlier. The inner membrane is, however, smooth. Second component is the nuclear sap. It is a clear, non-staining, fluid material present in the nucleus, also termed nucleoplasm. It contains raw materials, enzymes, proteins, and metal ions for the synthesis of nucleic acids, DNA, and RNAs, and ribosomal subunits. The third component of nucleus is the chromatin material. It occurs in a non-dividing nucleus as fine filaments termed as chromatin fibers. These fibers lie crisscross and give the appearance of diffuse network. Chromatin fibers are, in fact, greatly extended chromosomes. Two or more thick ribbon-like chromosomes appear at the time of cell division due to condensation of chromatin material. These are made up of DNA and proteins. The DNA possesses all the necessary information for the cell to function, grow, and divide properly. The specific segments of DNA are termed gene. These are the hereditary units. Next component is the nucleolus. Generally, one or more rounded bodies called nucleoli, singular is nucleolus, are present in the nucleoplasm. Nucleolus is a dense, dark staining, granular structure without a limiting membrane. It is rich in RNAs and proteins. The last component is the nuclear matrix. It is a network of fine crisscrossing protein containing fibrils which are joined to the nuclear envelope by their ends. We'll talk about the functions. The nucleus performs following functions. It controls all the metabolic activities of the cell. It brings about growth of the cell by directing the synthesis of structural proteins. It takes part in formation of ribosomes. It regulates cell cycle. Nucleus contains genetic information in the form of genes located in the chromosomes and is concerned with the transmission of hereditary traits from one generation to another. This is all about the nucleus. Now, in next slide, I will talk about the structure of Students, chromosomes are thread-like structures, usually present in the nucleus and become visible only during cell division. These contain hereditary information of the cell. Each chromosome is made up of two components, DNA and proteins. DNA is the most important component of a chromosome. In eukaryotes, chromosomes can only be seen during cell division. Cell division are mitosis and meiosis. These look like rods during the metaphase stage of cell division. Each chromosome consists of two arms called chromatids, which lie side by side along their length. The two chromatids of chromosome are attached at a point called primary contraction or centromere, that is clear in the figure. The detailed structure of a chromosome, however, will be dealt in higher classes, so you have to wait for that time. In this slide, we will talk about the types of chromosomes. A chromosome may have either equal arms or unequal arms. These depends upon the position of centromere. Therefore, depending on the position of centromere, the chromosome is of four types. Metacentric chromosome, the chromosome in which the centromere is near the middle and the two arms are almost equal in length is called a metacentric chromosome. Submetacentric chromosome, the chromosome in which the centromere is slightly away from the middle point and consequently its one arm is slightly short and the other arm slightly long is called submetacentric chromosome. Acrocentric chromosome, the chromosome in which the centromere is near the end and consequently its one arm is very short and the other arm very long is called acrocentric chromosome. Telocentric chromosome, the chromosome in which the centromere is at the tip of chromosome and the arms are on one side only is called telocentric chromosome. Students, every eukaryotic species has a fixed number of chromosomes in its cells. The number of chromosomes varies from minimum two, example Ascaris, to a few hundred in different species. However, in majority of the species, the number usually ranges between 8 and 50. In human beings, in us, there are 46 chromosomes in each body cell. There is always a pair of chromosomes of each kind. The paired condition of chromosomes is known as diploid, and a cell which has the full number of chromosomes, means two of each kind, is called a diploid cell. Body cells in human beings are diploid. A set comprising of unpaired chromosomes of each kind is said to be haploid, means only one, not pair. And a cell which has half the number of chromosomes, that is one of each kind, is called a haploid cell. The gametes in human beings are haploid. Thus, 46 chromosomes, that is two of each kind, are 23 pairs. In each body cell in human beings represent diploid number and 23 chromosomes. In gametes, means sperm or ovum, in human beings represent haploid number of chromosomes. Dear student, this was Girish Kumar Singh speaking with you. Hope these slides, explanations will help you to understand the subject and the topics during this period. Till then, remain at home, remain safe, and enjoy. Thank you very much for listening to me.